Thursday afternoon marked yet another two-a-day for the Florida State football team. Welcome outside here to the practice field, Seminole fans. I'm Scott Kotick for Seminoles.com. After catching up with head coach Jimbo Fisher following the morning practice, he said today it was just your normal run-of-the-mill everyday practice. He liked what he saw on both sides of the ball, yet he said there's much more room for improvement.
Good and bad. You see some of the youth, you see the athleticism. Saw a lot of the veteran guys played very consistent in what we know up front. Both sides, the ones I thought did a pretty good job up front. Made plays on offense with the ones. You know, really the ones and the two, ones on offense, ones on defense did what they were supposed to do. And the two surprised me at times. They really did. I mean, because again, some really quality people and good people were able to make plays that were not just given to them or butt them, or, you know, they actually executed plays and made blocks or got off blocks and, you know, did some things. So very encouraging about the depth and where we're going.
Over the past 4 years, having depth on that defensive line has been key to winning football games. Entering this year's fall camp, it not only pays off during game situations, but in the everyday practice, and especially when the Seminoles get to two-a-days.
It helps a lot, just because, especially we do two spots, so there's one and threes, twos and fours, and last year we were taking every single rep with the ones, every single rep with the twos, so being able to come out, you're able to maximize each rep that you make and be able to practice well, you know what I mean? I came in as a freshman with Timmy, and there was a lot of players in front of me, so I was able to really sit back and watch and get groomed really well with my technique, and I'm very comfortable with my technique, and I'm very excited to come, especially after such a great player like Timmy Jernigan, and be able to fill that spot, and I have tremendous pride about it.
In 2013, Nate Andrews' role was in the dime package exclusively. Entering this season, he's become much more versatile and will play in almost every package for Charles Kelly.
It makes me happy because I think I deserve it, and overall I think I help the team out. And I, like I said, I think I'll just be a good leader. And I mean, I'm not vocal, very vocal, but I just help out just doing the right things. I mean, I know the playbook more this year, so I got a better chance of playing. So overall, I feel like more of a leader right now. I might not be vocal, but I just feel like I just do the right things, and that's kind of leader I am.
Florida State gets back after it on Friday afternoon. Again, Seminoles.com will continue to be here for each and every practice of fall camp leading up to that August 30th game with Oklahoma State out in Arlington, Texas. Here on Thursday afternoon at the practice fields, I'm Scott Kotick for Seminoles.com.